You are listening to Bibi Tanga. He's a musician and a globetrotter who is bridging the gap between Africa and France. Tanga grew up the son of a diplomat in the Central African Republic and traveled with his father around the world. But because of a military takeover in his homeland, the family moved to France when he was just 10. Well, Tanga sings in English, French, and Sangho, that is the main language of the Central African Republic. His lyrics often send socially conscious messages, and he writes about everything from AIDS to immigration to slavery. Bibi Tanga, he is joining us via Skype from Paris. Bibi, very nice to see you. Very nice to meet you. We love your music. It really is. It's fascinating because you combine languages, you combine cultures. I mean, it really is kind of like this melting pot. Explain how you manage to come up with such a unique sound.
I'm just like this, you know. Thank you first, but, you know, since I was a little kid, we traveled a lot with my father, who was a diplomat. So I was used to listen to a lot of kind of music. That's the reason why we do this mixture.
And you've lived in four different countries. You speak many different languages. How does that influence your music?
You know, I speak Sango, which is the language of Central African Republic, French. I live in Paris. I speak English also a little bit, you know. and you know, I just try to do my best. This is just how I am, you know. It's just natural. There's no really complication in that, you know. That's where I am.
Do people try to box you in to label your music one way or the other? Or do you just basically say, look, this just defies any kind of tradition?
You mean what, by the choosing the music, about, you know, African music or what, when you say traditional?
Yeah, sure. How do you define your music? Do people try to say it's one way or the other, that it has to fit into a certain genre, whether it's African music or French music?
Okay, now, people used to say that it's a mixture, a real mixture, you know, like we have traditional and futurist music. Like we like to call it, you know, Afro-funk futurist music.
Afro-funk futurist music. I love it. I want to play a little bit for our audience here because I know this is an exclusive and it's new from your latest album. So let's just listen in a little bit.
Yeah.
Bibi, tell us a little bit about this song, how this came about. I understand that there is kind of a strange story behind it. I mean, a near tragedy after recording this. Give us a sense of what happened here.
Sort of a tragedy. You know, my friend, which is in the band, his name is Professor Alassad, he's on turntables, you know. And he used to use this sample, which saying, my heart is jumping. And then 2 days later, he had a sort of a heart attack, you know. Now he's doing well because we're still touring together. And that's the reason why we made this song about, you know, the things you love that can make your heart jump out of your chest, you know. So that was a tragedy before, but now it's a good story.
It's a good story. We're glad he's okay. You know, we've been talking to bands, we've been seeing bands a lot in the news lately. There's a band out of Russia called Pussy Riot, and these members, they were arrested for protesting against President Putin. They were performing at a cathedral in Moscow. And you've got musicians like Madonna coming out to support them, The Who, all kinds of folks who are speaking out. What do you think is the role of musicians in these particular groups? Do you think that they are effective in speaking out politically?
Yeah, I think, especially now, we have to get involved, you know. When you heard about something like what happened to the Pussy Riots, you know, it's a kind of shame. Could not happen in a country like Russia, but it happened. And for me, it's a shame, so we have to say something. You know, it's really bad because they're just playing songs, they just, you know, do their job, you know. You cannot arrest somebody for that.
And
that's not fair.
Well, what do you hope your band does for people around the world?
You know, we just get involved with some things. In some of my lyrics, you know, I talk about AIDS or malnutrition or something like that. You don't need to be involved all the time, but sometimes you have to do it, you know. We can do some, you know, just love songs, okay, but we have also to talk about what happened in Africa, what happened to some people like, you know, Pussy Riot or some, you know, if you see my point.
I see your point. Bibi, it is very well made, and obviously your music it's a big hit. It's got a great message behind it. We'll keep following you. Thank you very much. It's nice
Thank
to meet you.